You got that right. This soon, once again, I'm doing another VR thing, but unlike what I did myself this week, my own one with questions, it's more of the usual thing where I'm doing my own answers for someone else's, and who it is, once again, is a regular I've been doing it for in recent times, but hey, that's the way it goes. And unlike the last one, this one actually does have to do all video game related, but specifically music, which, hey, why not? The last one was more horror movies and all that. Anyway, so once again, it's VVc0w, and this time it's 6, not the usual 5 or even 10, but 6 video game music questions. I like this a lot because I'm big on music, as a very long video I did recently should show, even though it's not about video game music, although one of those was for video game music. Believe it or not, as most people would expect it, OutRun actually is not going to show up in this. I did that intentionally. But just the same, why I like this is also very difficult for me to narrow down, as I've always said about this kind of stuff, and when it comes to music, I'm really not good with that. I mean, I tried as much as I could not to go with all RPGs for every single question. I could have, easily. I could have just used the Final Fantasy series for the whole thing. But I limited myself to only one for that series anyway. It's not the only RPG that'll show up in this. Anyway, so let's just get to it. All 6, try to do as fast as I can. But I am going to play you some of each song. One of them, not to jump ahead, is about short songs. And that one literally is that short. I'm going to play the whole thing. So, whatever. And, well, yeah, there you go. The other ones I'll just chop off. You can hear a little bit and see what they're like, but none of them are really that long of a songs. I did that for my own sake. As usual, of course, I'll have links down below in the description to his channel and his original video, and as I always say, if you like this, you want to do your own answers or even video, that's fine, but do it on his thing and put the link to it there, because I'm just giving my own answers. I didn't come up with them, not this time. And I'll have the questions in order in the description as well, but I'm also, because that's just what I do now, I'll put time codes to when each one starts, because we all know how I drone on. Speaking of, let's get this going. So number one, and this is actually probably might have been the hardest one for me, just given how many I could have went with, but that's how it goes. Anyway, the first one is a piece of music from one of your favorite games, and this is the one I let myself use that thing I said where I could only use one for a whole series, which would be Final Fantasy, and I did with this one. And for some time now, many of you are probably shouldn't be surprised how much I like Final Fantasy 4 or 2, as it was called here. So yeah, there's plenty I could have went with from this, and not even really all that original ideas, you know, the prelude theme, even though it's different in every single Final Fantasy. It's the same song generally, but they put different spins on it. It's one of the things I always liked about it, actually. Or the actual main theme, or any other obvious guesses. So I didn't do that intentionally to force myself, but I like the music in the whole thing overall. There's some I like more than others, of course, that goes for anything. But with this one, I went with one that's probably not one of the more obvious choices, and it's not even one I memorized by name, even though I should by now. It's called The Land of Summons, and like a lot of these, I'll admit, I don't really have specific things I can say why I went with it or what I like so much about it, but like with this one, I just really like how it sounds, and it's just, I can remember exactly the part of the game it is when I hear it, even though I don't recognize the name as well as some other ones. And that's the kind of thing for me, that's how I don't know if it fits so well with this song like some other ones, you know, like 1-1 of Super Mario Brothers, but to me it's kind of iconic and it just sounds nice. Okay, the second one, I really don't have a lot I can say about it, but there is one thing I do want to mention about it. Two is a short piece of music from a game. Now, this is kind of the same, and a lot of us could think of many, and usually it probably would either be a game over theme, which I was very tempted to go with, but I wanted to do something different for a change, so I forced myself not to do that as well, or some kind of stage select song, which plenty of those are short, rarely are they long, or usually they're meant to loop, of course. Some game over themes do that too, but not all. Anyway, I thought some of those were too short, and there was a few I was going between like 10 seconds long, which it's enough, but to me, I wanted something a little bit better. So then one dawned on me, and I went with, and it's actually the first song you ever hear in the game, and I don't actually know what the correct title is. I know what it is, it's the main theme, but it probably has some specific name, but I couldn't find it around. It's called Track 1 on the actual disc, but hey, whatever. main title theme is what I'm going to give it its name as, but it's the one from a game I like a lot, Wing Arms. Always have liked it, still do. I just have the Japanese version now, unlike North American in the past. Cost less on the Saturn, of course. And you've already seen this if you saw the Saturn video I did the other day, but hey, coincidence. I was actually, a lot of them I was thinking over the Saturn for this because it's so tempting, but I limited myself there too. But anyway, it might be the first song you hear in the game, but it's a very good one, I think. And I'm going to play it for you in full because it is that short. Alright, number three, and while I said the first one was most difficult in terms of just how many I could have went with, this one is sort of on the opposite end. It's just, it's not something I think about at all, to be honest with you, and it's not even all that an interesting, I think, or original choice to go with, but this song is kind of important to me in general, ignoring the whole theme of the question here. But number three is a piece of music that reminds you of your childhood. It's not so much game music that does it for me, it's more like normal music that's not from games, just to throw that in. But anyway, the one I went with for this is a game I played definitely back then, and it's also a big reason why I like that game specifically, and is that song from that zone itself, which is my favorite zone in the whole series of Sonic, which is Casino Night Zone. It's a giant pinball table. But while most of us, and me too, usually think of fast, energetic music from Sonic games in general, the 2D ones or even 3D ones, and there's a lot of good music in the whole series overall, to me, Casino Night Zone, I always liked it a lot, even though it's very slow and mellow. To me, I don't know, it just kind of fits the whole theme and everything so well. I just really love the sound of it. It just does it for me. I don't know how to explain it. It's a big reason why I like that game and the zone itself. It just all goes together perfectly for me, and that's why I still like it that much to this day. And way back when, definitely, that was something that got my attention with it too. So even at that age. Alright, this is interesting and seems like something I would do, and yeah, I do definitely do this. I listen to music in games even if I have no intention of ever playing it or the entire series, because the only thing that even I like about it is music. There are ones like that, that's not what I went with here. But this is definitely one I would like to still play. In fact, I could have got it not long ago, but I went with something else that's sort of related to it. Again, Final Fantasy and RPGs. This is an RPG too, but lacking the Final Fantasy elements, so you already know probably what it is without me even showing it. I have played the demo, so maybe this shouldn't count, but then it's only a demo and not all the songs in it show up in that, but like many just RPGs in general, even ones I have and I like a lot, I've listened to the entire soundtrack to it on its own, so that's how I know about this one. And it's from Kingdom Hearts 3, and the song is called Selfless Savior. Again, I don't really have specifics I can give you for this one, I just, to me, it really stands out among even some of the other songs, and I really like how it sounds. I think, I'm not entirely sure because I want to ruin things for myself even though I've listened to the entire soundtrack that I can live with. I think it's saved for a specific boss. I can't be sure, so I'm just saying, I'm taking a guess. Don't tell me if it is, please. But it's a very good song. I like it a lot. That's all really I need to say. For once, I think I'm doing good on time, but we now come to number 5, which is probably my favorite of the 6, just because it reminds me of what I generally try to do most of the time I can, is bring up games that are, I call them the neglected ones, the ones that aren't ultra-famous, they're not totally obscure, but they kind of go ignored and all that. And even for me, oddly, despite what it's for, the Genesis Mega Drive, and how much time and effort I spend with it, and research and things for it, and just ones I know from the past, somehow this game escaped me, as I said, when I finally came by it and I got it. And I thought it was a good candidate for this one because it does have some really good music. I mean, some really thumping, energetic sounding stuff, and it's kind of got that quote-unquote stereotypical Genesis Mega Drive sound about it. It is an early game for it, too, so I thought it might be kind of interesting to go with for that reason, too. Maybe some of you might know it. I think I did a video for it on here some time ago, but anyway, it's called Jewel Master, and exclusive for it, as I think I said. And the name of the song, too, I like as well, because I actually don't know many of the names of the songs, so I had to look into this if it has a specific name, and it does. Spire Tiger. And it's just, like I said, it's a very, I don't mean it in a bad way, to be clear, a very stereotypical sounding type of song that you'd think of most for the system and many games on it. And it's a pretty good energy, high energy track, so I like it. There's one other I was very tempted to go with for a certain boss, and it's very similar to this, but that one was a little bit kind of, it's a little bit of, I don't mean this in a bad way, a mess, but there's a lot going on, and this one's a little bit more defined, so I thought it would be a good one to go with, and more would probably like it over that one. Not that I don't think that's a good song, too. It definitely is. Overall, the music in the game, I say, is very good, and I'd suggest listening to the whole thing in that way. Also playing the game. I definitely suggest trying it. And now we're at the 6th and final question, and this is a good one because it kind of forces me to do something I probably normally wouldn't have. I got nothing against handhelds, I like them quite a lot, and the one I went with is my favorite of the handhelds, the Game Boy Advance. But normally I really wouldn't think of handhelds that much for this kind of thing. I'd be far more tempted without even realizing it, going with something I played on the computer, whether it's exclusive for it or not, or consoles, which up to this point, that's what it's been. So it's good that it's a handheld one, and that's what number 6 is, a piece of music from a handheld game. And I went with one I like a lot for it. It's actually an exclusive for the Game Boy Advance. Although the songs in it are pretty much ones you've heard in 1 and 2 alone, but that's kind of why I wanted to go over this too, because while they are mostly similar, they're actually kind of not. They've tweaked them a little bit. So it's a song you know well enough, probably, and you can remember, but they've actually altered it slightly so it sounds like it's a little newer than you remember. I like that, and it's done in a good way. I can't complain with how they've tweaked them in this. So the game is Pinball of the Dead, and the name of the song is Magician Returns, which if you've played House of the Dead 2, even without playing this, I don't think I need to explain who the magician is. And he had a really good theme in too, so it's good here as well. And this is another one, like in the last one, I was tempted to go with another one just as much, but I opted for this one just a little bit more. It has a slight edge on it. And there you go. Those were my answers for the 6 questions all about game music. Had a little harder time than I thought with, but not so much that I can't give an answer for them. It always bothers me when I can't do that, so at least this time that wasn't a problem. It was more like, what do I go with? So it worked out. And I think I did good on the time, too, for a change. Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed it, and as well as the ones I chose, and I hope I played enough that you can understand why I went with each one, as well as whatever random, unfitting, I'm sure, gameplay I'm going to use for this, which as of this point, I still don't know. That's always last anyway. And once again, in the description, I'll have links to his channel as well as his original video. Again, if you really like the questions, you want to give your own answers, either typed or do your own video, as I'm doing here, go for it. But he's the one who came up with the questions. Do it on his video and put the link to your video and his thing, you know, all that. Not me. I'm doing my own thing. And I'll have the questions in order in the description below that, as well as time codes. So if you just want to get to whatever one I'm going on about, that way too. That's it, and see you later.